try and press the steer. Okay, so this is what he's like, is he?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh,
really?
Oh, he pulls a lot more normally, doesn't he? Yeah.
Okay. Right. What do you do in this situation?
I'll try and get away.
Yeah. All right. So you're like a typical beagle. You like the sound of your own voice.
Oh, God, yeah.
Do shut that door behind you. Yep. So that's with every dog you see, yeah?
Yeah.
What about if you don't see dogs? Does he still bark?
No.
No, so it's only dogs.
I mean, he can be a bit pulley, but normally that's because of his scent more than anything else.
Yeah, I mean, beagles, like spaniels and other type of dogs that are primarily incredibly sniffy, they can be somewhat difficult to walk because their nose is so powerful.
Yeah.
I mean, I believe they have the second strongest nose of any dog. I think it's the bloodhound that's got the best nose, and then it's the beagle. So you think what your typical dog is like, and then you've got the beagle.
Yeah, right.
So, do you want to unclip his lead, and he can just go and wander around in the garden if he wants to have a little look? So, have you had a trainer before?
Yes.
Okay, and what did that trainer do with you?
Was that the lady?
Well, first one, she kind of put it all down to aggression.
Aggression? There's no aggression in him whatsoever.
Well, that's what the second one I said. So
if aggression. I thought he was aggressive, I wouldn't have let him come face to face with rocks.
Exactly, yeah.
So you can tell from his bark there's no aggression. It's more like, I see you, I'm here.
Yeah. So we kind of got rid of her, didn't we? Because we did like one session. And
let me guess, was she a ForceFree Trainer? What did she try to do with you?
It was...
Avoid. Yeah. Don't let him off the lead.
Don't let him off the lead, ever.
She said about a stress bucket, so the more stress...
Stress bucket?
Yeah.
She said the way you've got to look at it is like he has a bucket,
and
the more he gets stressed, that means that he's the higher state of stress, so therefore if you feel like he's getting like that, just keep him in for a couple of days.
Oh,
and
fuck.
So we didn't take him out. This is insane, okay?
Because one, I'm seeing more and more trainers that say, oh, your dog's not ready to go outside because it gets him too stressed.
Yeah.
So what happens is the dog gets more stressed because it can't go for a walk.
Yeah.
So it's got all this pent up energy, and you hit the nail on the head, frustration.
Yeah.
But also, when he's barking, he's getting himself worked up. But if you're just removing him from the situation, or avoiding situations, you never teach him how to deal with that stress.
So you're going to
be here. I mean, how long has this been going on for?
I mean, he's barked since a puppy, but it's got particularly bad since, I live with Holly and Yogi.
Oh, do you? Yeah.
I used to. And since they live together, it got ridiculous.
Apparently you got a video for me.
Yogi.
Because Holly messaged me last night to say that I'm working with you, and apparently Yogi's doing really, really well.
Yeah, she said. But they were a nightmare together. He used to really dominate Ralph, and it's kind of got worse since then.
Yeah, well, a lot of the training we did with Yogi was to teach him how to... So you got a nervy boy. He's very jumpy.
Yeah, very.
One of the things we taught Holly with her dog was to, obviously, how to deal with that situation.
Yeah. And Yogi is great now. They haven't met again for a long time.
Because obviously Holly... I think she had a previous trainer, and nobody in London could help her, so she ended up coming down
the
here.
So we had this first lady, and the lady that was helping Holly then helped me, but really she didn't help, she just used to walk for me.
But the reality is, going back to what I said, avoiding doesn't fix the problem.
We are doing that, that's what we don't want.
So what happens if you avoid, every time you see a dog again, the pattern's still there. What a dog like that needs, because the bark's quite insecure.
Yeah.
And you can tell when his demeanour is quite insecure. When I told you to bring him in, he jumps straight away, and then noise in the garden, and he's jumped. So you've got an insecure guy. What he actually needs is somebody to say, "Hoi, stop."
Yeah.
And you see what happens, because if you actually put him in that situation, it's like, oh, okay, I don't mind.
Yeah.
I'm going to just get a little film of it. Because he wants to meet a dog.
Yeah.
As you said, you know that he'll be That's all right. That's, well, this one's on the lead and she won't go out.
Okay, oh, I just shut it. Just push that.
See, it's an initial response.
Yeah.
It. So remember, keep wrapping the sip.
Wrap a sip.
Okay, and you're going to let Ralph play with Rox in a second. But look, already the difference seeing another dog calming down. He's frustrated because he never gets to really meet other dogs because you're nervous about how he's going to be, but he's a friendly dog. But the reason you're nervous is because your other trainer has told you to avoid dogs because he's aggressive. He's not aggressive at all.
Yeah.
But this is the notion of ForceFree trainers. They don't read dogs properly. They don't want to stress dogs properly. So relax your arm a little bit. That's it. Ask him to sit.
Sit.
And then stand in front of him. As soon as he looks at you, say, go on in and lead him towards Roxy.
Go on
then. Break. That's it. So we'll shut this door. Drop his lead. Let him go. Yeah. So Ralph, I'm going to take this off your butt.
Yep.
Oh, you're a big wuss, aren't you? Great girl. Where are they gone?
Outside my
bed. Ultimate reward. I think this is what you need to see, that your dog can just...
Yeah, it's nice to see.
Yeah.
I think all we see is the...
That
and
bit
the,
we saw outside,
yeah.
And then you're like, oh,
and then
God.
We run
away.
I would encourage you to come down on some pet walks.
Yeah. People do know me better, though. When I've been out with
shortcut.